No, this ruins your welcome home here.
But boy, do we. We have archives on top of archives from Waylon Wednesdays and other appearances he made here on the show and on 103 WKDF. And we'd love for you to stick around and allow us to share them with you. And we will call this Requiem for the Outlaw. It's 6:01. Hey, Scully, country morning.
Country morning.
What's it like out there, sweetie?
We're looking good. We're going to start off with no accidents, no stalls, so be sure to give yourself extra time to deal with a heavy volume that'll be on the way. But right now, we're doing really good. I'm Officer Scully, 103 WKDF, Law Dog Traffic.
Michael Donegan, the Duke of Waylon News.
Also coming up, good old boy is gone. It's 6:03 of 103 WKDF with the P-Team News. I'm the Duke.
He was just marvelous, and, you know, God's got another great singer in heaven.
Glenn Campbell, talking about Waylon Jennings, died yesterday on a Wednesday. Waylon Wednesdays here at 103 WKDF had become a mainstay of this radio station over the past couple of years. Waylon dying at his home in Arizona after a long battle against diabetes and related health problems, died at a young 64 years old. But still, in his last year, he did more work than some artists do in their whole career, touring, recording, doing a weekly radio show. Let's look back at his life. Here's News Channel 5's Harry Chapman. She's on the bottom
in the jailhouse. Born in Texas in 1937, Waylon Jennings cozied up to the guitar at a very early age, learning chords from his mother. By the time he was 12, he had a job as a DJ. Bitten by the music bug, Waylon quit school when he was 14 and moved to Lubbock, where he met Buddy Holly. Holly gave Waylon a job playing bass with the Crickets, and it nearly cost him his life. He was supposed to be on the flight that killed Buddy Holly, but he gave his seat up to the Big Bopper, who had a bad cold.
You know, and they said, what do you think? The Big Bopper took your place and everything. I hate that happened to him.
After the crash, Waylon moved back to Lubbock, and by 1960, he was making music again. In 1965, Chet Atkins signed Waylon to RCA Records. Even then, Waylon seemed to be hitting a few sour chords, like the first time he played the Opry with Bobby Bear.
We'd both over tootsies, getting a Coke to drink. Anyway, just about the time we was feeling a little too good, he says, I got to go do a shot on the Opry, and Bobby Bear, and I said, he said, come go sing with me. I said, okay.
By 1968, he was releasing top five songs like Only Daddy That'll Walk the Line. A year later, he married Jesse Coulter, and the two would eventually have a string of hits together. Then came the decade that defined Jennings' career, the 70s. He was still recording hit songs, but he was also losing faith in the industry. Discouraged by the bureaucracy of Nashville, he started what musicians call the Outlaw Movement.
All I ever wanted to do was do the music, hand it to the record company, and let them do their job now. But what they want you to do is do the record, write the song, let them cheat you out of half of the money every way they can.
He hooked up with Willie Nelson and in 1972 assumed full control of his music. That same year, he had three top 10 singles. In 1975, he was the CMA Male Vocalist of the Year. By 1977, he didn't need Jennings anymore. His fans just called him Waylon. That same year, Waylon's Luckenbach, Texas went to number one. But it was a bittersweet accomplishment.
It's pretty well common knowledge that I hate Luckenbach, Texas. I hate that song worse than it. And I hate to hate anything, but it just got to where it would drive me nuts. I'd even put it at different places in the show trying to surprise myself with it.
In 1978, Waylon and Willie won a Grammy for Mamas Don't Let Your Babies Grow Up to Be Cowboys. And things got only better for the original Outlaw. In 1980, he recorded the smash hit theme song for the Dukes of Hazzard.
Just a good old boy.
Even with all the success, though, Waylon never denied the dark times, often talking candidly about his 21-year battle with drugs and how he beat addiction.
Hope that I find what I'm reaching for.
It was a career that spanned more than 40 years and saw 16 number one hits. Waylon's latest release is appropriately titled Never Say Die, and neither his music nor his memory ever will. Gary Chapman, News Channel 5.
Waylon Jennings survived by Jesse, his wife of 32 years, and their son Shooter. Funeral arrangements are incomplete. We'll be back with the weather after this.
Of all the in-studio performances by Waylon and friends over the last couple of years, it seems to be a favorite. Don't you think, Dookie?
Yes.
You probably know what we're about to play, because it's most likely your favorite, too. On the P-Team's Requiem for the Outlaw, Waylon Jennings, Can't You See? 103 WKDN. This is usually the show closer. When you see Waylon and the Waymore Blues Band in concert, most times they close with Marshall Tucker's Can't You See?
What that woman she been doing to me? snow.
Waylon Jennings, Sweet Jesse, the Waymore Blues Band in studio on a Waylon Wednesday, and it's the Waylon Wednesday Archives that we'll be going to very, very often this morning in the P-Team's Requiem for the Outlaw, 6:15. P-Team, Daryl.
Good morning, Carl.
Can you hear me okay?
Yes.
All right, good. What's up?
I'd just like to thank you for, as a listener, letting everybody understand and really get to know Waylon as the true caring man that he was. You know, he's always been, through the years, known as the tough redneck or whatever, and, you know, he was really a true caring man, and I know all of y'all at the station has lost a true friend, and only you could bring out the true Waylon and let everybody really see the inner Waylon that he was.
You're very kind, Daryl. Thank you for calling. God bless.
Okay.
If you have something to share with us, you don't have to be invited to call. It's an open invitation. 737-1033, pound PS34, Verizon Wireless customers, and
you've got mail.
Duke103WKDF.com.
V-Team's Requiem for the Outlaw, Waylon Jennings. Again, back to the Waylon Wednesday archives. V-Team gals, I think my baby, Sweet Becky's in here somewhere. Jesse. Does this include the Waymore Blues Band, or is this just Jesse on the piano? Jubal, anybody know?
I think it's just Jesse.
Oh, I love these. And remind me to play Angel in the Fire. That's very fitting. Storms live in studio 103 WKDF. Savage, Gina Lee. 103 WKDF, the P-Team's Requiem for the Outlaw, Waylon Jennings. That'll rip your heart out. I turned to Dookie after just a few bars of that song, and I said, man, I know Becky is just in tears.
Well, we were in tears the day she sang it in here.
Katrina, that'll rip your heart out, won't it?
Oh, it will, Carl P. I tell you, I was on the computer, and it came on CMT, and, you know, you were the first person I thought about.
Thank you.
Because I know you were such good friends with him. But
Katrina, Becky and I just left them. Becky spoke to Waylon and to Jesse. What is today? Today's Thursday. Spoke to them late Tuesday night. Go ahead.
It's Valentine's Day. Yeah. So, you know, I was in the car. I just took my husband to work, and I was just thinking, roses are red, violets are blue. Life wouldn't be right without Carl P. and Dookie, too.
That's sweet, Dookie.
That is very sweet of you
to
say
that. We love you, man.
Katrina,
my heart's with you.
You are now the P-Team
Poet Laureate.
Poet Laureate. Whatever that means. I heard it somewhere. I have no idea what that means. That's what you are, sweetie. Thanks. Country morning.
Country morning, Carl.
629-103 WKDF. Waylon's death is front page on practically every newspaper in the country today. Here in Nashville, the Tennessean, the headline country maverick made music his way. The Arizona Republic, in Waylon's hometown of Phoenix, country music and the Valley of the Sun, losing one of their most original personalities. Front page Dallas News, Waylon Jennings, quote, "I've never compromised, and people respect that." Travis Tritt last night was having a romantic dinner with his wife when he got the news. We've been told that Hank Williams Jr. is devastated. Merle Haggard and Waylon very close. Merle said last night, "Sometimes I was mistaken for Waylon. Sometimes he was mistaken for me. We go back a long way. He's one of a kind, and my feelings go out to Jesse."
Merle Kilgore, the senator, longtime manager of Hank Jr. and close personal friend and associate of Hank Williams, called the house last night and did indeed say that upon hearing the news, Hank Jr. went to his bedroom, shut the door, and had been in there, well, for hours when Becky spoke with Merle. I wouldn't be surprised if Hank Jr. checked in with us later in the show.
Waylon once said that the second most difficult thing he'd ever done was try to slide through the windows of the General Lee on the Duke set like Tom Wopat and John Schneider did on the show. The most difficult thing for Waylon? Trying to use the bathroom on a Learjet.
Well, we have something in common, huh?
Lord, it's the same old tune, fiddle and guitar. Where do we take it from here? Rhinestone suits and new shiny cars. It's been the same way for years. We need to change. Somebody told me when I came to Nashville, son, you finally got it made. Old Hank made it here. We're all sure that you will, but I don't think Hank done it this way. No, I don't think Hank done it this way. Look at it.
Waylon and Jesse after the three-night layover in Las Vegas. What How awful is that? Can't get to Phoenix without a three-day layover, three nights in Las Vegas. So we got there on Super Bowl Sunday. That would have been Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday night. We checked out on a, well, it would have been Waylon Wednesday, right?
Right.
Three nights?
Yes.
Rented a car from Hertz, by the way. And are they still number one?
Yes, they are.
Well, they are in my heart.
Yes, they are.
Because I got one of those never get lost OnStar kind of deals.
It's pretty cool, isn't it?
Oh, man, we would still be looking for Waylon's house if not for that. So we drove over. We drove across Hoover Dam and through the desert. And it's in the middle of the desert. I'm going about 79, 80. I don't know. I have to look at the document to see. And a 65. We were just talking about, and our friend Ronnie Barrett drove over with us. We were just talking about the speed limit and how fast I was going. Becky from the back seat, right?
How fast you going?
Well, 79, 80 out here in the middle of nowhere. Well, you'd better slow down. So I yelled at her, tell her to quit. I said, you know, I'm licensed by the great state of Tennessee to drive this vehicle.
I don't think so. Not like that.
Please don't speak to the driver. So, anyway, 3 miles on down the road, I'm pulled over by the Arizona State Highway Patrol. And by the way, hey, y'all, this beer is so hot. And the guy comes up and he says, sorry, you were doing 79, possibly 80 here in a 65-mile-per-hour zone. I said, oh, I'm so sorry. He says, where are you people headed? I said, well, he asked for a license, registration, proof of insurance, all that. I said, well, I have a driver's license from Tennessee. This is a rental car, and here are the papers. He says, okay, I'll be right back. So he goes back to the car. I'm guessing, can they access a computer to check out somebody's story or whether or not I'm wanted by the law or anything like that?
Oh, sure.
So apparently he did that, and he comes back to the car. And I'm looking in the rear view, and I see there's writing. And Ronnie and Becky are going, oh, we just told you to slow down.
Girl, he's been busted.
Yep, 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 yep. And Ronnie says, well, maybe he'll get a warning. I said, oh, no, he's back there writing, man. He's writing that to you. I guess he could have taken us in for reckless driving.
Sure.
You know?
Exactly.
But he comes back with the paper. He says, where are you people going in such a hurry? And I dropped Waylon's name. Going to see Waylon Jennings. He's just out of the hospital. We're from Nashville, and he and Jesse are friends, and we're going to see him. He said, well, okay, I'm going to give you a warning this time. And he said, you tell old Waylon, Officer so-and-so said hi. So dropping the outlaw's name.
You Waylon
saved
to get out of a ticket.
The Peaster, once again, that's a true story. And I told Becky, I said, baby, we'll scan it, get Dookie to put it up on carlp.com. Can you do that?
Yeah, sure. Shoot, chat.
Well, I'll bring it in because that's a true story. And I got to tell you, too, as we talk about Waylon today, he was so full of himself. He still had that sharp mind, that keen sense of humor, and what's the word? Disdain for Music Row? Is that, should I say that?
Yes, that's true.
Talking about Music Row and the jerks. And
that was his favorite topic.
The same old man. Same outlaw, Waylon Jennings, 642. Waiting on Hulse. Jerk. And he was to a lot of people. What a great man. What a generous man. And I've seen him do some things that I never expected him or a lot of people to do. And I'm talking about being generous and helping people. And he threatened me once. I witnessed him do something very, very, what should I say? It surprised me that he would give so much money, you know?
Yeah.
Just out of his pocket.
Just pull it right out of his pocket.
And he thought I didn't see him, but I saw him. And he said, Hoss, don't you ever say a word about this. Yeah. And that's the kind of guy he was.
And a friendly person, too. Yeah. We would go to lunch with maybe 15 or 20 people, and he made sure that he spoke to every one of us.
I'm loaded. But if you just joined the show, Becky and I were visiting with Waylon and Jesse. It was Becky's idea to go out and pitch in and give Jesse a break if we could. But we got out there, and, of course, he's surrounded by friends at all times anyway. So I don't know if we helped or got in the way, but we enjoyed ourselves immensely. And Jesse is such the the sweet host, and there was Waylon, just out of the hospital, Went back in for 3 or 4 days so he could rest. He wasn't getting rest at home, so he and Jesse went back to Mayo Clinic, and they came home the night or the day before we were to arrive, and they were just so gracious. Jesse threw a little dinner party for us and invited friends that we had met on our last trip out there, just wonderful people. And as part of the table setting, she had this, with Valentine's Day just a few days away, she used heart-shaped candles. And there was one just so beautiful, and I happened to have my camera ready, and I shot it and emailed it to Duke. Did you get that up somewhere, Duke?
Yeah, it's at curlp.com. Click on A Candle Burns for Waylon, and it's a fitting picture.
You're going to see that. And Dukey, too, has in his archives just a lot of candid shots of Waylon on Waylon Wednesdays and at Rolling Titan Thunder and at other places. How do they get to that?
You'll see it on our front page, carlp.com. In fact, there's several items related to Waylon there.
On the telephone, and you're welcome to join us telephonically, 737-1033 or pound P34 Verizon Wireless customers. Julie, the daughter of the late guitar great Grady Martin, is on the phone. Julie, what you got for us?
Well, you guys touched my heart. I didn't get to hear this live on the radio, but was told by a friend about apparently a Waylon Wednesday and a funny Grady story where he and Willie and my dad were in New York. And
he loved your dad.
I'm sorry?
He loved your dad.
Waylon, I mean, I really got to know Waylon on your radio, and what a great man. I guess I really didn't get to know that side of the business because he was just dad to me, and when I heard it last night, it just touched my heart, and I feel so bad for the family, but well, the funny Grady story was so cute. It made me smile, I sent an email to thank y'all for that because it was just really great. Waylon's really going to be missed. What a great guy.
That just doesn't get it. He'll be missed, does it? Just doesn't get it. Thank you, Julie, so very much. God bless.
God bless.
And Grady Martin, of course, one of the studio geniuses of Nashville, played sessions on many of the number one hits or songs for Red Foley, Buddy Holly, Roy Orbison, Joan Baez, Little Jimmy Dickens, and was on the road with Willie Nelson for almost 16 years.
That's Grady Martin's daughter there. That's Julie. Thank you very much for calling. Again, you can call 737-1033. Pound P is complimentary for Verizon Wireless customers. And as always, P-mail. Go ahead, Duke. What is that address?
Duke at 103WKDF.com.
Stacked up like yard dogs. We're averaging about, what, 10 or 15 a minute? It's amazing.
I got 25 emails in the past 10 minutes.
You've got mail.
See? It's still coming.
You've got mail. You've got mail.
Just a good old boy. Never meaning no harm. Beats all you never saw. Been in trouble with the law since the day they was born. Straightening the curves. Flattening the hills. Someday the mountain might get them, but the law never will. Making their way, the only way they know how. That's just a little bit more than the law will allow. Just a good old boy, they wouldn't change if they could. Fighting the system like a two modern day Robin Hood.
Hazard's theme in studio with Waylon on Waylon Wednesday. How long ago did the guy with the wonderful hairpiece come in? How long ago was that? We didn't even know he wore a wig at the time.
Oh, you're talking about Brad Paisley?
Brad Paisley.
No, he doesn't have a hairpiece.
You got that, Jubal?
You need to stop saying that.
Brad Paisley, guesting with Waylon and the P-Team on a Waylon Wednesday.
Let's see. Just a good old boys. Never mean no harm. Been in trouble with the law since the day they was born.
Straightening the curve.
There he is.
Flattening the hill. Someday the mountain might get them, but the law never will.
Making their way the only way they know how. that's just a little bit more than the law will allow.
Yes, hey.
We done a duet, Hoss.
Well, how about that, man?
The trouble is, we're going to be hearing it on the air a lot.
Oh, yes, sir.
Everything's done on the air.
We got us some archives, don't we, Duke?
I tell you.
Man, what a special thing to have that. Treasures. We have treasure. And you'll hear a lot of them this morning. The P-Team's Requiem for the Outlaw, Waylon Jennings. 653.
Hello?
Hey, go ahead.
Yeah, I would just like to say a couple things about Waylon. I met him. My wife worked for him for about 3 years. Yeah, I guess you could say she was kind of his personal assistant, mm-hmm. helping him out at the house and on the road, whatnot.
Yeah.
Traveling with him.
And what's her name?
And had several opportunities to meet him. And I was never a big country western fan. But I'll tell you what, he changed my mind on country music. He is the most generous man that I have ever had the opportunity to meet in my entire life. You just can't say enough about the man. He treated my wife like a daughter. And when she found out last night, she was very heartbroken.
Yeah, there are a number of people who have worked, as you say, for Waylon and Jesse, and they don't call it that. They treat those people, and I think they feel that a lot of these folks are family, and that's a fact.
Yeah, he wouldn't, you know, she'd go on the road with him and Jesse, and he wouldn't let her pay for anything. I mean, she was basically a part of the family. She treated right. him, she treated her like shooter.
Sure. That's how
I just, you know, my heart goes out to the family. I talked to, we talked to Shooter last night. He was getting ready to go out to Arizona to be with his mom. And, he said, the only thing he said about it was, don't feel sad for him. He's not hurting anymore. He doesn't have the pain. And, he finally caught that plane to meet Buddy.
There you go. Very, very well said, Tim. Thank you very much, man.
Thank you.
I perish the thought that Waylon would have heard him call his music country western. He would have got that butt kicked real good one time, wouldn't he?
Well, I tell you, out west, though, they do. They add that western word to it.
Listening to the radio out there, visiting a few days ago, and I heard the country and western. Hey, Chad, cut your radio down just a bit, man.
Hey, I was just calling to give my condolences to y'all, to the family, to everybody else. You know, me and my buddies, I have a 20 years old, and Waylon, he's had such an impact on us. You know, him, Willie, David Allen Coe, Hank, and, you know, we're all young. People look at us like we're punks. But I'm telling you, I'm still in shock about it. I didn't find out till about 4:45 this morning. Yeah. I just want to call and tell y'all my heart's go out to y'all, the family, and everybody else.
Thank you, Sam.
Y'all take it easy now.
Yeah, I'm glad you called. The P-Team's Requiem for the Outlaw. Remembering great Waylon Jennings. I almost said the late great Waylon Jennings. It's very hard to say. Very hard to say it. Tried to express that to Becky last night for a few minutes. You know, although I knew it, and I wouldn't be so hurt for a while. But then about a couple minutes later, it just hits you. Hits your heart. And then you realize, wait a minute, this ain't a dream, man. It's really happened.
They say part of the grieving process is denial.
Lost.
Not believing they're dead.
One of the greatest of all time. 103 WKDF.
30 years ago, the Nashville music community didn't know what to do with him. Today, they're reeling from his death. Waylon Jennings died in his sleep, according to his management firm in Chandler, Arizona. He had moved there from Nashville. Country music losing one of their most original personalities, dying at the age of 64. Last night, fellow Country Music Hall of Famer Brenda Lee.
It was just an ill-perceived persona because he was as far from being an outlaw as you could be. But he was a nonconformist, and He made no bones about that, and he did things, as Frank Sinatra said, my way. And he did them very well and very good and was accepted.
Wow. Wow. Brenda Lee?
Yep. Waylon Jennings was a mentor to Andy Griggs.
I remember looking at the control room, and there's a glass shield between the vocal room and the control room, and I could see our reflection. And I saw me look, standing, singing beside Waylon. And I nearly fell apart, man. I sure did. That's the same guy that helped me get out a whole lot of heartaches. You know, that helped me get over a whole lot of women.
You know what? I think that's Andy talking about visiting us on a Waylon Wednesday. Remember that day?
I think you may be right.
And they sat right here. And indeed, he could have turned to look into the control room.
Mm-hmm.
And as I'm looking now, and I see our reflections, I'll bet you, I don't know where you got that, but I'll bet you he's talking about visiting with Waylon on Waylon Wednesday. Shortly after all the trade magazines and the fan magazines had the story of Waylon and Andy chasing down the busload of tourists.
Yeah, it was around that Remember time that Waylon took Andy under his wing and even did a duet in his debut album for him.
And they came in here, and we got Waylon a number of times, but this is one of the better ones. They're sitting here. We're actually talking about that episode that all the fan magazines and other media were talking about, and we call our friends over at Gray Line. Is it Gray Line Tours?
Mm-hmm.
And we march about 30 or 40 freshly scrubbed Canadians.
We put the tourists in the studio with Waylon.
So Andy could have very well been talking about that day. And I was in Waylon's office just 2 or 3 days ago. And they're working on trying to show Jesse how to work her computer.
Right.
The shooter had hooked up for it. She signed on to AOL and had hardly any idea how it worked. And we're sitting there working on the computer. And I'm looking around at the walls. And I see a plaque that Andy had sent Waylon, and I'm guessing it was for a gold record or maybe just a plaque to say thank you, because he did indeed, Andy, have a wonderful relationship with Waylon.
Mark Chestnut named a baby for Waylon.
My wife was pregnant with our first son at the time, and he told me, I don't even remember, we had another name picked out for him before he was born, but before he left, Waylon said, now all I want out of this deal, he said, the only thing I want out of this is y'all name that baby after me. He said, boy or girl, name it after me. And I said, well, it's going to be a boy. And he said, well, that's good then, isn't it?
Waylon Chestnut is 7 now, and unfortunately, he never got to meet the man whose name he bears. In the mid-'80s, Waylon befriended Carol Spinney, the man who plays Big Bird. When they appeared together in the Sesame Street movie Follow That Bird, Big Bird, of course, was on stage rolling Giant Thunder.
Yeah. And on the bus and visiting with us for most of the day. And I sat there talking to Big Bird out of the...
That's kind of weird.
Without his head and his pecker, you know.
Well, a few years back when Waylon was still smoking cigarettes, he was chatting with Big Bird and some ashes fell into the feathers and Big Bird caught fire.
Big Bird!
Waylon Jennings said he did not fear death.
It ain't no big deal, you know, because it's just like getting born. You didn't have nothing to do with that either, you know. So if it's going to happen, it's going to, you know. If it's not, it's not. And it's kind of like the music business, you know. You can let them run you off or pick your own time to walk out, you know. And you can do that. I still believe you can do that with death.
Waylon Jennings. Back with the weather after
Wednesday archives. What? Of Waylon, Loretta Lynn, and David Lee Murphy in studio.
Hey, I got to tell you a story, okay?
Please. One time I was out of it, and
he wasn't out of it. He just acted that way, just to get me to walk in the
room. Sure, I was. And Loretta, we were in Long Beach, California, and I couldn't even see my hand in front of my face. I was wiped out, and Loretta was trying to walk me to get me in shape to sing. And I kept trying to lead her into the dark corners, and she wouldn't go. Now, up until that time, I had never seen Mooney. And so, I mean, I just, you know, trying to talk my way. I thought, well, I got this maid. She's walking around everywhere with me.
Anyway.
You thought you were going to sleep with Loretta Lynn.
I had every intention in the world of doing that. And I didn't care. And I was going to get on top of a building and shout it the next day. I'm going to tell everybody I knew.
And you didn't care about Moody. You didn't care about Duke.
No, I didn't know what he looked like. And when I looked at him, he looked like... It's a guy that, you know, when you look at somebody and say, well, now, if I was going to whip him, what would I do? And the only word I could come up with was run.
He loved you.
I love him, too. He's my buddy.
He was a good one. I'll tell you.
Past Waylon Wednesday, Loretta Lynn, David Lee Murphy, and Waylon in studio 103 WKDF. All right. Good. And for those of you just joining us, live in studio, David Lee Murphy, Loretta Lynn,
I sound like Waylon Jennings. Cash with a palsy.
Will the circle be unbroken by and by, Lord, by and by? There's a better on the way in the sky, Lord, in the sky. Well, I was standing by my window on one cold and cloudy day. When I saw that hearse come rolling for to carry my mom away, will the circle be unbroken by and by, Lord, by and by? There's a better on the way in the sky, Lord, in the sky.
Key change, Roger.
Undertaker, 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 please drive slow. For this body you are carrying, Lord, I hate to see her go. Will the circle being broken by and by, Lord, by and by? There's a better home away in the sky, Lord, in the sky.
Welcome
all right,
back.
Any word.
I'll swing. You all just get it.
We sing the song of our childhood. Hymns that have made us strong. One that Mother Maybell taught us. Hear the angels sing along.
Will the circle be broken by and by, Lord, by and by? There's a better home awaiting in the sky, Lord, in the sky. Undertaker.
Yeah.
Oh, Undertaker. Undertaker, won't you please drive slow? Or look, woman, that you are carrying. I hate to see her go. Will the circle be unbroken by and by, Lord, by and by? There's a better home awaiting in the sky, Lord, in the sky.
Sounds like we were having a good time, Doogie.
Yeah, we were.
Well, I
think P-Team's Requiem for the Outlaw, Waylon Jennings, Loretta Lynn, David Lee Murphy in studio with the Outlaw in the Waylon Wednesday Archives here at 103 WKDF. We'll be going back to that. We'll be getting into that well a lot this morning. 737-1033 if you'd like to join us. Pound P, free for Verizon Wireless customers. And Dookie takes all the email. His address is
Duke@103wkdf.com.
Again, you get a busy signal. That's because every line is on hold. People have been waiting for some time. Like Michelle here has been holding for about how long, Michelle?
Oh, I guess 10, 15 minutes.
Yeah, I just looked at the clock here. We have a clock that tells us how long people wait. It's right at 16 minutes, and we thank you for holding.
No problem.
What do you have to say about Waity Hot?
Well, I grew up listening to Waylon all my life. That's all I'd ever listened to. And